How's it going, everybody? This is Paul Maxey, and I feel like doing a video about Joust, mainly the Atari 2600 version and the Atari 5200 version, which I have in box and I have ready to go, and I can play it with my Atari joystick thanks to my converter. But I think I'll also include footage and gameplay of the real Joust, or at least a very close simulation of it, which you're seeing here. So we can compare, even though that's going a little bit backwards. After you see the real graphics, you know, you go back to the console versions, you're going to think it's weak. But, you know, you got to understand that it's very hard for them to program these arcade games onto your home consoles. You sure weren't going to get a nice intro screen like this on your 2600 showing, like, a demo. That would have been nice. Makes me kind of hyped to have the real Joust. But there's something special about playing these arcade games on your home systems. And Joust is one of those games that it seems like we need to have it for every system. Now, first I'm going to go and plagiarize this video from the video game years. And let's review Joust a little bit.
Arcade, great.
William's Joust. Frickin' ostriches.
John Newcomer went out to make a flying game, and he didn't want to use spaceships because those were cliche even at that time, so he had knights riding ostriches.
And I actually liked that game and played it more, I'd say, than any other video game ever.
So you flap your little ostrich wings, and you gotta hit the other ostrich knights, just a slightly higher level at least, and then you hit them off, and you collect the sort of like epic eggs for bonus points.
Yes. Do you ever wonder where Super Mario Bros. 2 got the idea for riding on ostriches? No? Now I feel ostracized.
That's the entire game. One screen, ostriches flying on by. It's bizarre. It's some sort of like really weird, you know, like heavy metal animated world or something going on.
I'm gonna go stick my head in the sand.
Honestly, the best part about Joust, other than the whole ridiculous nature of it, is how satisfying it is to just splurt on top of the enemies and turn them into eggs. I don't even know if that's a word, but that's what it feels like, and it feels good.
Yeah, thank you, guys. That's from the video game years, and you can find those videos on YouTube, or I've seen them on Amazon Prime, and, I mean, it's really addicting to watch those. Those are well-made videos, and I don't think it's plagiarizing if I admit that, you know, I didn't make them. Now, as for the real Joust, maybe we'll make this video in the order of how we saw these games, and we first saw Joust, obviously, in the arcade, and it was a different kind of game back then, of course. And it's awesome. Now, this is pretty much the real Joust, and boy, it's pretty awesome. I got a lot of video games, but I'll always make time to play Joust. Playing this version, I'll play with the PS2 controller, but I'll also plug in an arcade stick made for PlayStation, so I can really feel like I'm playing a Joust game. So that's just to show and remind us all what the real arcade version of Joust really looks and sounds like. And we're not going to judge Atari 2600 or 5200 for not being perfect. We're just going to, at least I hope, we're just going to judge them on the merits of how well they could pull it off. Because we all wanted some Joust entertainment at home. Mind you, both the 2600 version and the 5200 version do two-player co-op. Or two-player battle. However you wish to play. Now, another thing is the creator of Joust thought about actually making a Joust movie, just so you know. And there's a little bit of a clip of it right here from John Newcomer talking about how he wanted Joust to be a movie.
Joust the movie is it's a little hobby I've been working on. I guess the transition is I started off as a toy designer, then I became a video game designer, and then I would like to become a movie designer. So I had always thought that Joust would make a great movie. The technology was never there for what I had in mind, but now it's more than there.
Huh. Now, Joust, I think he talks about Joust 2. The reason you never saw Joust 2 come home to home consoles was largely of how the screen was made in more of a vertical type shape. You'd think they could have worked around it, but that would have been a hard game.
Joust 2 is the trivia question of all time, I guess, was that there actually was a sequel. We tried to resurrect Joust in 1985. Didn't make many games, but this is at a time when very few video games were selling, and there wasn't much of a video department anymore, and we had met with some of management. We were trying to figure out, let's try another game, and so we were considering resurrecting and doing a sequel of either Robotron or Joust, and they decided to let's give Joust a crack at it.
Yeah, man. I mean, I like Joust too, and of course I have it for different systems. Now, come on over here with me, my friends. We're going to travel through my giant home. Actually, it's only 400 square feet. And we're going to come through on my promise of doing an Atari 2600 review of Joust. Look at the title screen you get. Not too shabby. Got to say thanks to Steve Marco for my 2600 Junior. I paid him for it, but he gave me a good deal because he felt bad about how I got ripped off on the internet on another attempt to get a 2600 Junior. So there's the title screen. And I think we'll add a little, one of my favorite 80s songs to make it more 80s authentic. It's actually a really good bass in this song, Our House. So here we are playing a little Joust on the Atari 2600. Pretty good. I like Joust with Atari 2600. As basic as it is, they did the best they could, man. You picking up eggs? And mind you, you can play two-player co-op. Interesting in Joust for the 2600 how the eggs go flying around. That's different. And I think different is okay. You feel like you're playing a little bit of a different game when you play the 2600 Joust. Very playable. I guess I couldn't make the characters with two or three colors. I was just asking too much for the 2600. But I like how if the eggs are allowed to hatch, you get a different colored enemy. Like that. Look at the blue one. And they're badass. Oh. And you got that hot lava there. Speaking of hot lava, you ever bite into a Stouffer's French bread pizza? Straight out of the oven back in the 80s. It's like hot lava. You just couldn't wait for it to cool down out of the oven, could you? You bite into it, it's like hot lava, and you're stuck to it. It's like you won't let it go of your mouth, and you just let it fry the roof of your mouth off and lips. And then you're stuck with these little pieces of meat hanging from the roof of your mouth for about a week or two. There's a pterodactyl! I think you can kill him, but it ain't easy. You want me to try? Oh, it's the end of the level. So that's pretty cool. The level after the pterodactyl still has exposed lava. Oh, it's an egg level. Actually, that wasn't the pterodactyl level. I just took too long. So Extra man at 20,000. Gotta love it. Since I was doing Joust, I was considering plagiarizing, like, jousting footage from, you know, First Night or one of those night movies and all, but I thought, well, that's a bit of a stretch. So that is our Atari 2600 version of Joust, and I like it, and I think I'll be in the mood to play it. But I've got the 5200 version out, and last but not least, for comparison, on this Atari review day, we're going to play some 5200 Joust. And to be honest, I think it's awesome. However, after comparing it to the arcade version, such as we just did, it's not as awesome. But it plays good. I found that playing on advanced is the way to go. Sure, you want to get a high score, but it looks very monochrome on the first two easy levels, because when an egg is left to hatch on the first level of anything less than advanced, it hatches right back to an easier bird until you've gone much further. I found that advanced is like the arcade. You let an egg slip, and then you're going to get harder riders challenging you. Now, I've got my joystick, so I can play. And what's great about the fact that I just played the 2600 version, this Joust does look impressive to me. Whereas when I first turned it on, I was like, oh, that's it? Because I'm stepping up from the 2600 graphics. And you feel like you have more area to play. So there's a little comparison for you guys on... Even though my theatrics and videos and music are part of my deal, what I'm trying to show is a direct comparison from the Atari 2600 to the 5200. And I don't know how I got on the topics of Stouffer's French bread pizzas, but yeah, hot lava. You bite into that Stouffer's French bread pizza, you got a mouthful of hot lava. But anyway. So notice, I like playing on advanced because watch what happens when I let these eggs go about their natural hatching process. There, you got a white one. He's worth more points probably, and he's tougher. So I just realized that today, that I'm going to play on advanced from now on. Yeah, man, there's a big area wide open. This is the first 5200 game I ever played, because I would go play Joust at my friend Nicky's house, or Nick now. It's funny how when you're a kid, all your friends had a Y at the end of their name, and then you try to call them that, like Ronnie or Nikki, later in life when you find them on Facebook, and they don't want anything to do with you, man. They're grown men. Except for my friend Johnny. Johnny Segura. He was Johnny as a kid, and by God, he's Johnny as a 48-year-old. Right, Johnny? I like that about Johnny. That's like if I was Pauly. Well, there's Pauly Shore. But I'm Paul Maxey. If it was Pauly Maxey, that's just a bit too much, don't you think? Ah, on advance, you got the wipers in effect. I keep high score records, and if I have high scores for different score settings, I write that down. So I'm going to have a different column. I'll have my column for skilled level and advanced, because you got to cut yourself a break if you're playing on harder level. You got to know that was harder to achieve that score. Ah, egg wave. So unlike the 2600 version, these eggs are in place. I'm not sure why the eggs on the 2600 version are flying around, but it makes for an interesting gameplay aspect that I think we all welcome. But you know, you're always a little bit suspicious of Atari. You figure that the eggs were floating because it was like easier to do, or it was the only way to do, or something. So there's your 5200 Joust. I mainly felt like doing a review of it because I got my 5200 out, and I thought I'd make a meal of it, so to speak. And I can tell this, I've run out of steam on making this this video interesting, so we'll cut it off. One last thing. The hand that reaches out to grab you is pretty authentic in 5200 version. See that hand? And then you can reasonably fight it. Not so easy to fight in other versions of Joust. You can actually give this hand a run for its money. Look at that thing. Oh, he got me. And of course, there is the pterodactyl level. Let's see if I can kill this last rider once he turns blue. Uh-oh, it's a pterodactyl. And he's making noise. Oh. He cooked my goose. Yeah, look at the blue. It's a blue one. And the blue looks nice. That's a nice color. And that's why I wanted to switch to advanced, because I felt like I needed to see some different colors. And that blue is looking nice. Let's see how many points we get. I got 43,800. Let's see if I can kill him. Oh, he's stuck. Oh, no. I don't know if I'll kill him or not. He's tough. It was a tie. Come on, let's kill this guy to finish my video. Yeah! 45,300. So do the math. That's worth a lot of points. 43... That's like 1,800 or 1,500 or something. There you go. All right, guys. So that's it, the 5200 version, after I showed you the 2600 version, and of course the legit arcade version of it. So there's 5200 for all systems. I don't know how good a video this was, but add it to my collection. All right, you guys, have a good night. Maybe it's not so good because I'm sober. All right, see you guys.